Hey guys and welcome back. So in these lectures, we are going to be installing Vuforia 8 in Unity 2020 and deploying it to Android. Now there's a lot that has changed from Vuforia 6. First up in Unity 2020 is that the entire Android deployment process has been significantly simplified. What does this mean for you? Well, if you recall the Android deployment lecture from Vuforia 7 tutorial, well, Unity 2020 saves you a massive headache by again having Android SDK and JDK integrated right into Unity. I will show you how quick and easy this process is in the upcoming tutorials. So right now, we're going to be learning the following: how to download and install Unity Hub and install Unity 2020, set up Vuforia 8, and 3. Export to Android. Now before I get started with this Vuforia tutorial, if you are interested in learning more about augmented reality, then I have 3 courses that you can check out. One is a complete course on AR with Vuforia, and the other second course is on integrating augmented reality with the Internet of Things, and the third is my ARCore MasterClass. If you want to be the AR expert, then check out the links down below. Okay, so first up, we're going to be installing Unity Hub, mainly because it allows us to manage multiple versions of Unity and packages very easily. So you'll see why in a moment, but for now, type in Unity Hub in Google and click on the first link which says Download Unity. Over on this page, click on Download Unity Hub, and once downloaded, double click here where it says Unity Hub Setup.exe. The installation is pretty straightforward, so just click Next right through. Click Finish and allow access. Now with Unity Hub open, click on Installs, and this is essentially where you're able to manage different versions of Unity all in one place. Here we're going to install Unity 2020. Click Add and select Unity 2020.1.0A23. It's currently in alpha, so it will have a few bugs, but by the time you watch this video, it should be out of beta by then. Click Next. Now for us to export to Android, we'll need Android build support. With all these 3 checkboxes checked for SDK, NDK, and JDK. This is where all the magic happens behind the scenes. Before, there was a laborious process to set all this up, and now Unity have finally made this easier for us. Click Next, agree to the terms and conditions, and sit back and relax. The download may take a while, so pause the video here. Okay, now we have Unity 2020.1 installed. If all was successful, you should have this little icon right over here showing that it has Android build support. Click on Projects, and to create a new project, we are going to click this drop-down box next to the new button and select 2020.1. We'll call our project Vuforia 8 app and click Create. Now for some strange reason, we had Vuforia 8 baked right into Unity 2019. In 2020, however, I'm not quite sure why the option has been deprecated, but I'm sure that it's just because it's an alpha build. Now once it's out of beta, I really hope that you'll see the option to install the Vuforia package directly from Unity. For now, we're just going to click on this first link that will allow us to add Vuforia engine to Unity. Click agree and then click on this link to import. The link that you go to for this install is at the following address: developer.vuforia.com/downloads/sdk-download-modal. Back in Unity, I've already have this imported, so you can go ahead and import Vuforia. You will know that this import was successful if you see Vuforia under the game object menu. Click on Vuforia engine and select AR camera. Accept the Vuforia license if it prompts. And on AR camera, open up the Vuforia configuration, and you'll need to input the app license key. Click Add License or go to the Developer tab on the Vuforia Developers portal. Click on License Manager. And if you already have a license on it, then click on it. Otherwise, you'll need to select Get Development Key. Now, I'm just going to copy this key back into Unity and paste it in this box. Other than that, you can select if you want to use AR Core if your device supports it. I'll select optional. If your camera was found, it'll show right over here. so make sure to connect your webcam right now. From my experience, Logitech webcams work the best with Vuforia and are compatible with Unity. Next, we go back to Game Object, where we'll be creating our target marker. Click Image and then Import. Now you can either add in your own image or add in one from the database. No matter what image you use, make sure that you print it out. So this image that I'm using, you can get from Google by typing Vuforia Mars Astronaut. So if you use the image from the database, select Vuforia Mars underscore images, and then select astronaut as image target. Now we need to add in our augmented game objects, 3D object, and let's select a sphere. And now we just adjust the scale and position of our sphere so that it sits on top of the image target. Don't forget to make the sphere a child of the image target. Now for this to work on Android, go to Build Settings, click Add Sources, and select Android to switch our build to this platform. And before we deploy it to our mobile device, let's first test it out with a webcam to see if it works on PC. Great, we are good to go. Now back in build settings, connect up your phone and ensure that it's in developer or USB debugging mode. If this is done, you should see your phone under run devices. Okay, if everything was set correctly, you can go ahead and click build and run. Name our app Vuforia 8 and here we go. If you get this prompt, then just ensure that you allow USB debugging on your phone. Say always allow from this computer. Click OK and it will show that the phone is connected. Click retry and it should build now. Okay, and if it all worked well, you should be able to see your sphere in augmented reality. Mine looks a bit jittery, but that's only because I'm recording simultaneously. Remember, if you are interested in learning more about augmented reality, then I have three courses that I've mentioned. One is a complete course on AR with Vuforia, and the other second course is on integrating augmented reality with the Internet of Things or IoTAR. And the third is my AR Core MasterClass. If you want to be an AR expert, then check out the links down below. Thank you for watching and we'll see you in the next lecture.